One of the communities I'm proud to represent is Island Park. And as you know, your agency is overseeing a multi-million dollar FEMA project to deal with flooding after Hurricane Sandy. And what I'd like to let you know is that after, now we're 4 years gone, the flooding in Island Park is still pretty atrocious. And what I'd like to do is show you a photograph of a school. Let's see if I have long enough arms to do this. Of a school that has persistent flooding, where parents have literally handed their children, this is the right side of the brother, where parents have handed their children through the car window to the school educators there because there's no way to pass through. And this was not after a hurricane. This happens in nor'easters, of course, but also heavy rains and tidal flooding, and it's gotten to a point where people are just exasperated and don't think anyone is going to come and help them. So in light of what we're seeing there, thank you, I would just love to hear from you about the progress that you're making on this and urge you to please devote all resources necessary toward accomplishing it, because frankly, when you drive down the street in Island Park, some wouldn't be crazy to confuse it with flooding that happens in much less developed countries, and it's a shame that we have to have this on Long Island.
Yeah, I understand, Senator, and I sympathize. There were probably almost 5,000 public assistance projects that came as a result of Hurricane Sandy, Island Park being one of them. I know a little about most of them. What I do know about Island Park, I think it's a $40 million project, and $1.8 million, I think, has been released for the design and the study. March is the deadline for that to be submitted to FEMA, and in March, FEMA will decide if that project is worthy of the release of the rest of the $40 million.
Okay.
So it's close. We got a couple of months, and I'm not sure how long, but I think it has to be to FEMA in March, and they will decide shortly thereafter.
Okay, your agency is also one of a number that have concurrent but overlapping to an extent projects in Island Park dealing with flooding, and frankly, your local agency representatives have been very open in working with us, and I appreciate that. I would love to have your commitment to work and help get Gozer and some of the other agencies involved to come to the community and just let people know what's going on. They saw last week more flooding. I obviously showed you the picture of this school. They would just like to know what's happening, and I think more information is certainly better than less, and I'd love for you to work with us on that.
Thank you, Senator. I appreciate it. Our recovery staff, they take a beating sometimes because things take so long. And a big reason for that is, in a lot of these projects, the work has to be done before FEMA will reimburse. But our people in our recovery section, they work hard, they advocate for their constituents. They can be right there with FEMA every day in and day out, fighting for New Yorkers. We've actually thought enough of that program to remove it. It used to come under the Office of Emergency Management, but when we redesigned the Division of Homeland Security Emergency Services, we made recovery its own entity. We have a deputy commissioner who runs it, and it's really a complicated process. I knew nothing about it before I came to this agency. I've learned, a little bit, certainly no expert, but what I do know is they work hard, and they do a good job, and they advocate for New Yorkers.
Okay, well, thank you for your responsiveness, and I agree with you. Let's just please keep Island Park on the front burner, and let's please work to educate and inform the residents of Island Park as to the work you're doing and what's to come.
Thank you, Senator.
Thank you.
You're welcome.